Hello and welcome back, dear students. Wish you all stay happy, healthy and safe at home and do your studies regularly and properly. I'm Yojana Parakh and today we are going to continue chapter number 8 for standard 11 students from Organization of Commerce and Management. The name of this chapter is Sources of Business Finance. In this chapter, we have already studied about the meaning of business finance and its need and importance. And then we saw the sources of business finance. There are two sources. First one is owner's fund and second one is borrowed fund. In owner's fund, there are three types: equity shares, preference shares and retained earning. In that we have seen the meaning of equity share. Let us quickly revise it. And then we will see the characteristics of equity shares and types and meaning, characteristics and types of preference shares. And then we will see the difference between equity shares and preference shares. So now let us begin. Equity share, that means the shares which are having last right to receive dividend, and at the time of liquidation they have the last right to redeem their capital. So that kind of share is called equity share. Now you must be thinking, when the equity share is having last right to get the dividend and capital, why would anyone buy equity share? So there are some benefits which are provided to equity shares. That is why people are attracted to buy equity shares. First thing, that equity shareholders are true owner of the company, because they take the highest risk if we compare it with the preference share. So preference shareholders will get a certain rate of dividend at a certain time. Their dividend is fixed. The rate of dividend is fixed. And equity shareholders have no fixed rate of dividend. And after paying all liabilities and after paying the dividend to preference share, then if the surplus is remaining, then it will be paid to equity shareholders. So preference shareholders are safe, but equity shareholders take risk. If the company earns profit, which is more, and it would be remain, some surplus would be remain after paying liabilities and after paying the dividend to preference shareholders. If there is remaining surplus, that would be paid to equity shareholders. Otherwise, they would have nothing. They won't get any pay or any dividend. So that is the risk which equity shareholders have. But there are some benefits also. What are the benefits? That equity shareholders are true owners. So they can attend general meeting, and if any decision is to be taken in the company, so they can attend that meeting and can influence that decision. Second thing, that as they are owner, and in companies ownership and management is separate, but shareholders, equity shareholders, cast their vote and elect the director. So if these votes are casted according to the number of shares, not according to the person, according to the number of shares. That means if any person is holding 51% equity share of the company, so that person can directly influence the management, because his vote will be counted according to the number of shares, and as he is having 51% shares, so majority votes will be given by him, and that person would be director. So that director, as he is elected by that particular equity shareholder, he will work in favor of that equity shareholder. So in this way, that equity shareholder can influence the management, because voting is done according to the number of share. And this is the first benefit, that they can influence the management by electing director. They have the voting right and they can attend general meeting also. And second benefit is that equity shareholder get the benefit of price fluctuation because equity shares are registered in recognized stock market, and there the benefit is to purchase and sell the equity share. And in purchase and sell, there is the price can increase or decrease, and that profit of fluctuation in price will be with the equity shareholder. So they get the profit by price fluctuation in the stock market. So this is the second benefit. And third benefit is that the preference shareholder will get a particular rate of dividend that would be fixed, but equity shareholders their dividend is directly related with the profit. So if the profit is more, they will get more return. And if the management is in their favor, so obviously they will try to make maximum profit, and that would be a treat for equity shareholders, because after paying the fixed amount to all liabilities, debenture holders, preference shareholders, then the remaining amount of profit will be equally distributed among equity shareholders. So it can be that their dividend can be increased with the increase in profit. Fourth benefit is that they will get the right shares and bonus shares first. They have the right to get the right shares and bonus shares first. So if they will get right shares or bonus shares, that means the dividend which will be given on right shares and bonus shares will be there. So in this way, they will get additional dividend. So these are the four benefits which equity shareholders get. So this is the reason which attract the people to purchase equity shares. First one is that they have voting right, they can elect the director, and they can attend general meeting also. They can get the benefit of price fluctuation in the stock market. Third, they can get the benefit of more earning. If the profit is more, they will get more return. And fourth is they have the first right to receive right shares and bonus shares. So these are the benefits which are given to equity shareholders, and that is why they are ready to take the risk. Now let us see the characteristics of equity shares. First is the true owner. They are the true owners of a company because they take the highest risk, and at the last they will be paid their dividend or their capital. Same as like sole proprietorship and partnership firm, in every business unit, after paying all the liabilities, the remaining amount of profit will be with the owner. Same way here also, the remaining amount will be distributed among the equity shareholders. So that is why they are called true owners of the company, and also because they are taking highest risk. Second thing, they have the right to vote and elect director. Third thing, rate of dividend which is not fixed, and that dividend is directly related, their profit is their dividend is directly related with the profit. So if the profit will be more, they will get more return. If the profit is less, they will get less return. And if there is no surplus profit, they will get no return. So it is the risk they are taking. So their dividend is not fixed. So it may be that they may get more dividend as compared to preference shareholders, or they may get no return, no dividend. So in this way, their dividend rate is not fixed, and their dividend is directly related with the profit. Now, fifth thing is general meeting. Equity shareholders can attend general meeting and can take participation in the decision-making policy. Sixth thing is repayment of capital. As I told you that equity shareholders have last right to get dividend and repayment of capital. So at the time of liquidation, their capital will be repaid to them at last if the surplus is remaining, otherwise not. If the surplus profit is not there, if what is profit? See, when liability is lesser than asset, so that more amount of asset will be counted as profit, and from that profit, after paying all the liabilities, that profit will be distributed as dividend, first to preference shareholders, and then if it is remaining, then it would be paid to equity shareholders. Now it can be that that particular profit amount cannot be certain, so their profit, their dividend can be increased or decreased. At the time of liquidation, if the surplus profit is remaining after paying all liabilities and after paying to the preference shareholders, that remaining amount will be paid to them as repayment of capital. If the surplus is not there, they won't get any repayment of their capital. And equity shares cannot be redeemed during the existence of company. When the company is running, the equity shares cannot be redeemed because they are the owner. But it can be purchased or sold, while the preference share can be redeemed during the existence of company. So first thing is that equity shares cannot be redeemed during the existence of company. When company is continue, the equity shares cannot be redeemed. At the time of liquidation only, they will get the repayment of capital. And at the time of dissolution, that means at the time of liquidation, if the surplus is remaining, then only they will get the repayment of their capital. It is shares of qualification. When the director has given consent and there is a provision in memorandum of association, so the shares will be given to director, and those shares will be considered as shares of qualification. So this right is also will be given to director, and that will be considered as equity shareholder and director too. Next is capital benefit. What are the capital benefits to the equity shareholders? As I told you, first thing, they will get benefit of price fluctuation. Second thing, that if the right shares or bonus shares are issued by company, first right will be with the equity shareholders. That means the right shares and bonus shares will be first given to the equity shareholders. If they do not want to take that, so then it will be given to the general public. So they have the capital benefit that they will get the right shares and bonus shares, and on that they will get the dividend. So it would be added to the dividend to their equity shares. So in this way, they will get more return on their investment. And second thing is that they have nothing to pay for the bonus shares and right shares. So this is the capital treat for them. Tenth is registration of shares. When the equity shares are registered in recognized stock market, so because of purchase and sell of the equity shares, they will get the benefit of price fluctuation, and that benefit will be their profit. Due to increase and decrease of price, they will get the profit of price fluctuation. So this benefit is also there with them. These are the characteristics of equity shares. That equity shares, equity shareholders are true owners. They have voting right. They can attend general meeting and they can elect board of directors. Third thing, that their rate of dividend is not fixed and their dividend is directly related with the profit. Then at the time of dissolution, they have the last right to get the repayment of their capital, and they cannot get repayment of their capital during the existence of company. And if the surplus is remaining, then only they will get the repayment of their capital. Next is they will, and also if the director has given consent and there is provision in memorandum of association, so the director can also be given shares, and that benefit, that shares will be called shares of qualification. So that director would also be equity shareholder. And if as this equity shares are registered in recognized stock market, so they will get the benefit of price fluctuation. So these are the characteristics of equity shares. Now let us see the types of equity shares. There are three types: ordinary equity shares, sweet equity shares, and other equity shares. Now let us see in detail about ordinary equity shares, sweet equity share, and other equity shares. First thing, that ordinary equity shares are compulsory to issue because the company cannot start without equity shares, and ordinary equity shares are those kind of shares which they have to publish first, and that is compulsory to be issued. That is why the ordinary equity shares are called true owners of the company, because they take the highest risk and their dividend rate is not definite, is not fixed, and it is directly related with the profit. And the company can issue ordinary equity share according to their requirement. Next is sweet equity share. That is, company allots shares to its directors, person who are working in the company, that means employees. So these people who are working in the company get the first benefit to get sweet equity shares. The person who possess special knowledge have first right to get sweet equity shares. And this shares, why these are called sweet equity share? Because they are given at discount and sometimes even without consideration of cash, that means for free they are getting shares. And at the time of distribution of dividend, they will get dividend also without paying anything for sweet equity shares. So this is the second type of equity share. These are called sweet equity share. Why? Because they are given to the employees or those who are working at a special post, those who are having special knowledge, and to directors. These are given to directors or those person who are working in the company and have special knowledge. So they have the first right to get the sweet equity shares, and these shares are given to them at discount rate or without any consideration of cash. And at the time of distribution of dividend, they will get the dividend also. So this is the benefit for the employees of the company or director of the company. Next is other equity shares. Now, other equity shares are of two types: equity share with voting rights and equity share with different rights in relation of dividend and having voting rights too. We know that equity shareholders are having voting right, but sometimes it is the other equity shares are given to them in which they have the voting right. That means it can be count that for one equity share, they will get two voting rights. They will get two votes. So there is a special voting right which is given to equity shares. So this is the first type of other equity share. And second thing is, it may be that equity shares are issued with double voting right and also with a fixed rate of return up to some extent. So that is called equity share with in relation of dividend and having voting rights. So these are the three types of equity shares. First one is the ordinary equity share, which is general and every company has to issue. It is compulsory for every company, and company can issue this equity shares according to their requirement, on which the rate of dividend is not fixed and it is directly related with the profit, and they take the highest risk because their dividend is paid at last, their capital will be repaid at last if the surplus is remaining. So there is no fixed amount which they will get in return, and they are the true owners because they take the highest risk and they will get the benefit at last, monetary benefit at last. But still, why people purchase this ordinary equity share? Because they get voting right. And also they have the right to get right shares and bonus shares, and they will get the benefit of price fluctuation in stock market. So this is why people buy this ordinary equity share. They become the true owner, and they will get, if the profit is more, they will get more return. So the characteristics or explanation about ordinary equity share is that every company is compulsory to issue ordinary equity shares because they are the true owners, they take the highest risk, and their dividend rate is not fixed, and even their dividend is not definite when they will be paid their dividend. And these ordinary equity shares are issued by company according to their requirement. Second is sweet equity share. Why these are called sweet equity share? Because they may be given at discount rate or without any consideration to the person who is working in the company. That can be director or any employee or a person who has special knowledge. So these are given to the person who is working in the company at discount rate or without any consideration of cash, and at the time of distribution of dividend, they will get dividend on this equity shares. Third is other equity share. There are two types of other equity share: equity share with voting right, with special voting rights, in which for one equity share there can be two votes. And second is equity shares with different rights in relation of dividend and having voting right. Equity share with special voting rights and special rights in relation of dividend. So there can be that they may get a fixed rate of return on their investment. They may get a fixed dividend up to some extent. So this type of equity shares are called other equity shares. If the rate of dividend is fixed, it may be considered with preference share, but along with voting rights. That is why it is called other equity shares, which are having dividend, which are having special voting rights and different rights in relation of dividend. So this make it different from the preference shares. So these were the three types of equity shares. Now we will see the preference shares. Let us see the meaning of preference share. The shares having first right to receive dividend from company's profit at the time of liquidation of company have first right for getting repayment of capital. Such shares are called preference shares. Equity shares have last right, and preference shares have first right to get dividend from the surplus, from the profit. And at the time of liquidation, they have the first right to get the repayment of their capital. This kind of shares are called preference shares. Now let us see the characteristics of preference shares. First one is dividend. Preference shareholders have first priority to get the dividend, and their dividend rate is also fixed. Second is right to vote. Equity shareholders get right to vote for the election of directors, and also they can attend general meeting and take participation in the decision making policy. But preference shareholders can cast their vote only to the matter which is related to them. So only in the matter which is related to preference shareholders, for that only preference shareholders can give their vote. Next is preference. Who will prefer to buy preference shares? Those who wants to get steady income, and those who wants to invest in safe security. So they will prefer to buy preference shares because they will get steady and fixed income, and their capital would also be secure. Next is market price. The market price of preference share does not fluctuate much or does not change much. So their market price will remain same, and also there won't be much change in their rate of interest. So that would also be same. Mostly steady. not much fluctuable. Next is proportion of risk. Now, preference shareholders have priority to get the dividend, and at the time of liquidation, they have the priority to get the repayment of their capital. So, their risk proportion is somewhat lesser than equity shares. Next is repayment of capital. As I told you that at the time of liquidation, after paying all the liabilities, preference shareholders have first priority to get the repayment of their capital. And then if the surplus is remaining, that would be paid to equity shareholders. So these were the characteristics of preference shares. First, that they have the priority to get the dividend, and their dividend would be fixed. They can cast vote only in the matters which are related to them. Those person who wants steady and fixed income and wants to invest in safe securities, they will prefer to buy preference shares. And those who wants to take risk, they can purchase equity shares. Next is market price. So market price does not fluctuate much of preference shares. And even the rate of interest would also would not change or vary. Next is proportion of risk. The risk is lesser as compared to equity share in preference share. Why the risk is less? Because they have the priority to get the dividend, and at fixed rate and at the time of liquidation, they have priority to get repayment of their capital. So if after paying liabilities, the surplus is remaining, first it will be paid to preference share, and then if surplus is remaining, that would be paid to equity shares. So in this way, the risk is comparatively less. It is not that they have no risk, but risk is there, but comparatively less than equity shares. And at the time of liquidation, they have the first priority to get the repayment of their capital after paying all the liabilities if the surplus is remaining. So first it would be paid to the preference shares, and then it would be paid to the equity shares holders. Now let us see the types of equity preference shares. Types of preference shares. There are two types of preference shares. Actually, there are many types, but here two types are given to you. First one is redeemable preference shares before 20 years, redeemable preference share after 20 years. As I told you that equity shares cannot be redeemed during the existence of company. It would be only redeemed at the time of liquidation. But preference shares can be redeemed before 20 years of the company or after 20 years of the company. That means first type is the preference shares which have right that they can redeem their preference shares after issuing the preference share within 20 years, they can redeem it. Or otherwise, the second type is when the company has issued preference share after 20 years, they can redeem their preference shares. First one is after issuing the preference share within 20 years, they can redeem it. Or second one, after issuing the preference share, when 20 years are completed, then they can redeem their preference shares and get repayment of their capital. That means preference shares can be redeemed and get repayment of their capital during the existence of company. First one is before 20 years and second one is after 20 years. But equity shares cannot get repayment of their capital during the existence of company. When the company will be liquidated or dissolute, that time only they will get the repayment of their capital in equity shares. But preference shares can get the repayment of their capital during the existence of company. There are two types. First one is they can redeem their preference shares within 20 years, or second one is that they can redeem their preference shares after completing 20 years. Now let us see the difference between equity shares and preference shares. First, basis of difference. So first basis, compulsory. Equity shares are compulsory to issue for each company, but preference shares are not compulsory to be issued by each company. Second is rate of dividend. In equity share, rate of dividend is not fixed, but in preference share, rate of dividend is fixed. Third is rights. Equity shares have voting rights and they can elect managers or directors of the company, and also they can attend general meeting of the company. But preference shareholders have voting right only in the matter which is related to their interest. Fourth one is risk. Proportionately, comparatively, equity shares have more risk and preference share have less risk. Investors who will invest in equity shares. These shares are preferred more by investors who wish to take risk and speculate, gamble in shares, who wants to get benefit of fluctuation of price. So speculators or those people who want to take risk, because when the risk is more, the return can be more. So those who wants to get more return will invest in equity shares. But preference shares are preferred more by such investor who wish to get fixed and steady income and want to invest in secure capital or in secure safe securities. So they will invest in preference share. So in preference share, the return will be fixed and steady, and no one can speculate, because in preference share the price do not fluctuate much. But in equity share, as they are registered in recognized stock market, their price fluctuate up to much extent, great extent. So the speculator will get the benefit of price fluctuation, and the risk is more, so the return would also be more in equity share. So those who wants to get more return and who want to take risk and who want to speculate, they will invest in equity share. And those who do not want to take more risk, much risk, and who wants a fixed and steady income, they will invest in preference share. Next is market price. Equity shares, there would be increase and decrease in market price of shares. But in preference share, proportionately, the price of share remain fixed and do not increase or decrease much. Seventh is addition in capital. Here, as they will get the benefit of right shares and bonus shares, there can be addition in their capital. But in preference share, there is no addition in capital. In equity shares, capital can be raised by equity shares, by right shares and bonus shares. But in preference share, capital cannot be raised. So these were the difference between equity shares and preference shares.